I think that'll work right there. I normally have the V in the rootstock. And I try to pick out the appropriate size that matches up with with my
Oh, that makes a nice cut.
This is a copy of a French grape grafting tool, but they weren't big enough, so I made my own
For pecans.
For pecans and walnuts, because they
It's a hell of a tool.
Really nice. I can almost make that work there, but I can't. So I'll move it up here. I was going to try to get another graft out of it. But this is
it's a really nice cut.
You can see it matches up there pretty good.
Yep.
Make sure you're down in there good, and
it's a really nice match.
And if you match caliper, you get a good match on the other side as well.
Absolutely.
And you can actually have other people, you know, you pair them up, hand them to the next guy, and they wrap them.
Sure.
You could do quite a number of them. And we did over at Indian Hills Junior College. We went over and grafted a bunch of stuff, and we had
90% takes.
Some, not only takes, we planted that many. I mean, we took it to the field. And what I really like to do, if I'm going to do a bunch of them, is I like to have the graft wood prepared. I usually do a wax. It's not a paraffin. It's a paraffin beeswax type of a graft.
A mixture of the waxes.
Mixture, and it paraffin will flake off and fall away, and I like that it gives it a little more body and it'll stay on.
What's the percentage?
It's not necessary in bench grafting, but if you're going to the field, and I just paint it, whatever I adopt a color code, and you can paint the signs so that you don't have to. You know
what variety
you're using. It's color coded to the variety that, yeah. Like if you're using five or six different ones in a orchard or whatever, you can go to the field with a bucket of graft wood with some ice on top of them and pick them out of there and go down the line. And
yeah, I understand. And you know which cultivar is color coded.
Yeah, you can put. Now we'll need to take you. What I usually do then is you can put these in a bucket or something long enough for the root. I like to cover up the sign and everything, so. Cover it up with not wet but moist sawdust.
Sure.
And if you can put a lot of them in here, yeah. Like you could put probably 15 or 20 in this box, and either tent them or do something to keep the moisture on here. I even just cover them up, and then the buds will start to push, and you'll get push on your rootstock as well.
Sure, I've seen roses where they do the same type of thing.
And then you can have them be a you can put them out later. You got to baby them a lot if you're going to put them out the same season. And what we did over at Indian Hills, we didn't have adequate people, so we had one guy. He was he took the buckets home and tended them and got them healed, grafted and healed in. They didn't grow a lot the last year because we left them in the buckets, put holes in the bottom. This is what they had, and we put rapid grow on in a diluted form about every watering or every so often, and they didn't. And then we moved them to the field this spring.
That's what I was going to ask you. So you graft them this spring, care for them through the fall this year. Then do you heal them in at the same year and then plant them the next spring?
You can do, you can, if you got the capability of taking care of them, you know what I mean? If you are doing the care and you have enough help and water and fertilizer, and you know, you can maintain them out in the field. But I put fruit jars over them, and you got to worry about getting too hot. And, you know, it's a lot easier to deal with them inside or in a protected greenhouse or, you know, something like that. But
I see. Okay. Right on.
Something to maintain a better control. And this is just sawdust that we happen to have here. Yep. Now we didn't label that.
I was gonna say it's NC4 pecan. I meant to bring some.
And it's in the truck.
Shoot.
But you can just take this one home with you, and we'll
all right. There we go.